I know it's now been aborted training, thanks to the president's executive order and the attention that was given to the plan to just go forward with it anyway. But Christopher Rufo has actually obtained the info about these training sessions. And I think you should know what was being planned for critical race theory training within the Centers for Disease Control, the CDC. Here you go. And this is all from Christopher Rufo, who's been the guy unearthing all of this information. He was on Tucker Show recently. It's really fascinating stuff. In sessions, the first three sessions, as we just discussed, were racism, sexism, and other systems of structured inequality. Then teaching CDC employees that they must address institutionalized racism and really set things right in the garden of a racist nation. This is all from the official training materials that they have already taught at the CDC in the past, I'm sure, and were about to teach again, if it were not for the Trump executive order on this. In sessions 6 through 9, the CDC claims that, quote, racism is a public health crisis and that systemic racism, there you go, systemic racism leads to police killings of unarmed black and brown men and women and leads to the disproportionate impact of COVID-19 on communities of color. See, systemic racism, that's always that we've already talked about that. Well, what is systemic racism? Where does it exist within the system? Find me where it exists. Who's responsible for making it happen within this system? Who's pushing the decisions or the framework that leads to this systemic racism? Rufo continues here. In sessions 10 and 11, the trainers will teach CDC employees that they must target and destroy the values of focus on the individual, the myth of meritocracy, and the myth of American exceptionalism and white supremacist ideology. All of this is textbook critical race theory. This is what is being taught, friends. End quote there. This is what is being taught in federal institutions. With your tax dollars, employees are being told, this is what you must believe. Federal government bureaucrats are trained, right? That's that word, trained to think this way, trained to think this is true. And yet, we're supposed to believe this is in any way helpful. This is going to build a better society. And in the final session of the CDC teaching, quote, employees are taught how to become activists. They will be encouraged to join an anti-racism collaborative with 8 collective action teams focused on communications, making scientific publications anti-racist, and influencing policy and legislation. The whistleblower who came to Rufo writes, quote, I thought maybe they would wisely cancel this training series. Instead, we got a message this morning confirming, this was yesterday, the pressure to participate is palpable, and if you don't, you will have to explain why you aren't a racist. That's right. Friends, in the middle of a pandemic, the CDC is spending time on white supremacy and destroying white supremacist ideas according to these training materials like the meritocracy exists. It's amazing, isn't it? But Russ Vaught, who is the director of OMB, he came out and said, glad to report, per the president's directive, the training is canceled immediately. So, sanity prevailed this time around, but that doesn't mean that it's usually winning. That doesn't mean it's usually the case. Friends, we've got to continue to look at this and shine the light of, honestly, public outrage on this. I mean, it is stunning, stunning what we keep seeing with all this stuff. Really is. Really astonishing. Oh, one more thing. I got to spend more time on this tomorrow before we get to roll call. But a judge in Pennsylvania has said that some lockdown measures are unconstitutional. You don't say. Think about this. We've had businesses shut down. We've had mask mandates put in place. We've had all these things. No legislation. This is just by executive fiat. I mean, we've had a stress test of how much America will accept tyranny, and we've just all decided to go along with it. Oh, sure. Why not? What's the worst that could happen? We're seeing what the worst is that could happen. It's the dissolution of our freedoms, our rights, our property, all because people are panicked and so scared all the time because of the media. Darn it.
Hey, Team Buck, thank you so much for watching The First on YouTube. If you like this video, please click that little thumbs up button so then it will log as liked. And also, if you want to see more great content from The First, please click subscribe.